Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today I'm doing a blender recipe and I'm using the other jar that I showed you of my Blendtec blender. That is B-L-E-N-D-T-E-C, in case you're curious about the blender. But I received it recently and I have been putting it to some use and I really like it a lot. And I wanted to show you something other than the one recipe, which was a soup. What we're going to make today is hummus. Now, I haven't made hummus in Betty's Kitchen yet. I had a perfect opportunity to do that when I made an accompaniment that a lot of people use, which is pita chips. But I paired that with an asparagus artichoke dip. And I just felt like I was finished, and so I moved on from there. But then when I came back and decided to do hummus, I decided to give you a different pita chip recipe, and those are Savory Pita Crisps, if you want to look them up. Either one will do as an accompaniment for hummus. I'm going to show you what goes in here, and I might as well put it in at the same time. This is the twister, and actually I will twist it as it's blending. It blends in one direction and I twist in the other direction and that scrapes down the sides. But for now, we'll take the lid off and put these ingredients in the order that they were specified in the recipe. Now this recipe did come from Blendtec. I didn't invent it, so it's just a little bit spicier and different from your typical hummus recipe. I'm putting in 2 tablespoons of extra virgin olive oil. Then I have 2 tablespoons of fresh lemon juice. You can squeeze that from lemons freshly, or you can use lemon juice from concentrate, and that is pretty equivalent. 2 tablespoons lemon juice. Next comes 2 tablespoons of tahini, and that's not an ingredient that I use often. I don't think I've used it in Betty's Kitchen before, so I'm going to just do a little explanation. It is sesame seeds that are ground up until they form a nut butter. So there we have 2 tablespoons of tahini. You can buy this in a jar at your grocery store, or you can use a blender that is powerful enough to make a nut butter and just buy sesame seeds. Nothing other than sesame seeds is in the tahini that I use. And if you were to blend it yourself, you need nothing but sesame seeds. We have 1 clove of garlic, and you just get to throw those in. You don't have to mince them or chop them. And now I have chickpeas or garbanzo beans. And also, I've drained those. You can see they're very dry, but I've reserved 1/4 cup of the liquid that was in that can. And it was a 15 ounce or 14 ounce can, just a normal size can of garbanzo beans that you might find at your grocery store. It doesn't matter what brand. If you have a favorite brand, then use that. So all of these are going in. And then that reserved amount, which is 1/4 cup of the liquid that was in that can, will be placed in here as well. Next comes our roasted red bell peppers. We need 1 cup, and that's what was in the 12-ounce jar. I drained off the liquid, but here are the red bell peppers that are roasted. And the last is a little bit of seasoning. I have 1/2 teaspoon of ground cumin seed, and I have 1/8 teaspoon of cayenne red pepper. So this is going to be nice and flavorful. So we'll just put that in and we're ready to put our lid on and blend. Now this I would consider to be a dip. So we would look through our settings here. I haven't turned it on, but it's plugged in here to this counter and the settings, the light, the display has lit up, and you can also see the settings, and one of them right here has dips at the center. So I'm going to hold on to the top and actually pivot it counterclockwise, and there's an arrow to show you if you forget which way to go with it. But I do want to have control of that. So I'll go ahead and do that before I press dips, and it will just count down until it's done. And it should be perfect and ready to eat. So this just cut off. So I'm going to take this out, and this is a nice orange color, but you know, we put those red bell peppers in there, so that's why it's so vivid in color. See what it looks like? And it's going to be dip-like. It's kind of a soupy dip. I'm going to pour it into a bowl. Here we go. Isn't that pretty? And how smooth. This blender is designed to speed up and slow down as needed in order to come up with the correct consistency for the item being made. So it's really quite nice. I'm enjoying it a lot. And there we have our finished roasted red bell pepper hummus. I hope you enjoy the recipe. Here we have our finished dip, our hummus. And it's a different color from what you're used to because of the red bell pepper. Don't worry about that. It's just going to taste all the better. And I'm using my savory pita crisps over here. They're still fresh because I made them just a few minutes ago. But I'm going to dip in and get some of this. And I'm mainly going to concentrate on the dip, the hummus. Mmm. That is superb. I'm honestly not the kind of person to like that particular recipe, but something about the combination of flavors is just wild. It's perfect. And it's great with the crisp. And I'm not a double dipper, so I won't go back. Rick will appreciate that. I don't think he cares. But there's quite a bit here, and we usually put some wrap over it and put it in the refrigerator, so I don't want to have double dipped into it before that happens. So here's a nice hummus dip that I hope you'll enjoy coming from Betty's Kitchen.